So far, it seems like many assessments are being done from different government agencies from South Korea, the United States, as well as Japan. But South Korea's military so far has said that the latest missile launch flew about 960 kilometers with an altitude of 4,500 kilometers. Now, this is alarming to the international community because the Pentagon is assessing that this could be North Korea's third intercontinental ballistic missile. However, it's a little bit different from the July launch, the Hwasong-14, because it has improvements. The July launch had a flight time of about 45 minutes, whereas this missile launch had a flight time of about 53 minutes. So we see that North Korea is definitely improving its missile technology. And another cause for concern is the fact that there was a splashdown, which many are suspecting that it was a test for a re-entry vehicle for more than one missile, and this would be vital to completing its intercontinental ballistic missile technology. Now, South Korea's president has convened a National Security Council meeting in regards to the North Korea missile launch, and South Korea, in response to this missile launch, has conducted a precision strike live fire drill for about 20 minutes near the eastern sea border with North Korea.